You know when you get something and you buy it and it comes through the post and you just think, oh, hallelujah, it's just every bit as wonderful as I thought it was going to be. That's why I felt about these glasses. Woo, January went on for a little while, didn't it? I feel like that was one of the most intense months I've ever had. I don't know why, because I've had more stressful months, I'm sure, with things, you know, like health crisis and having new babies and deaths and things like that, but it just felt very, very long and very intense. Anyway, let's remove ourselves from the problems of life and just bask in my favourites, just for 10 minutes, okay? It's frivolous, it's completely shallow, but it's an escape. Aroma Active Laboratories. I have a feeling that this is a sort of sister brand to Aromatherapy Associates. In fact, I'm pretty sure it is. And I love pretty much everything from Aromatherapy Associates. They do the best bath oils, I think. I can't think of a better one, right? They're pricey, but you only use a tiny little sort of half capful. So it lasts for a good long while, but they are just so well blended. You properly get an effect from them. It's like it's like being in a spa or something, you know? Anyway, that's quite expensive, that range, but this range is not. It's distinctly affordable. There's another thing that I have that I was going to show you. It's like an overnight face balm, which is really, really good. But these are bath salts. Now, I know that I did say, and I've done a whole feature on it before, I'll link to it in the description. And I basically talk about the fact that I buy 20 kilos at a time of Epsom salts from Amazon in a huge, big, looks like a builder's tub of sand or plaster or something like that. And I use a whole mugful at a time when I have a bath. And that's, I feel like you then get the full effects of the Epsom salts. And I've always been a bit sort of sniffy about pre-packaged, pre-perfumed salts. However, these are outstanding. And they're not horrendously expensive in comparison. It's got a pre-blended dose of oils in there. So it's sort of all bound up together and very, very easy, and you just pour them in. I pour loads in, so it would get quite expensive for me using these on a regular basis. But if you want something that's treaty but not extortionate, then they're just lovely. And when I use them, I think I got 3 uses out of this. I'm sure that you would get more. Each time I was just completely knocked out afterwards. So I thought they were really, really good, but it's a brand well worth looking at as well. I think that they're only in Boots, but I'll double check that and I'll put the details below. My next favourite is a non-beauty thing. And I don't know whether this will go up on Instagram before you see this video or after, but basically, I wanted a pair of aviator spectacles, right? I don't know whether you watched the series Mrs. America. It's so good. It's got Rose Byrne in it, it's got Kate Blanchett, and it's all about the sex equality wars in America. Anyway, Gloria Steinem in Mrs. America, not the real Gloria Steinem, although she also, they've styled it on her, so I suppose she also did wear these, has the most amazing glasses. And I think they must have slightly tinted lenses. Anyway, since last summer, I've been looking for the perfect pair of aviators that are just on the right side of sort of retro, okay? And also Gloria wears them over her hair to sort of kind of pinch her hair in at the side. Oh my goodness. I'm absolutely obsessed with these glasses. Now they haven't got my lenses in yet, so I think I'm gonna get sort of non-reflective, tinted. I really want those ones. I always think they look quite creepy when they're on men for some reason, but on women, fine. You know those ones that react to the light? and they get darker when you go outside, so they can be sunglasses and you can wear them inside. I've got a feeling that's going to be horrendously expensive, but I sort of don't care because I love these so much. They're a million miles away from the glasses I would normally wear, but I just love them. I love them. You know when you get something and you buy it and it comes through the post and you just think, oh, hallelujah, it's just every bit as wonderful as I thought it was going to be. That's what I felt about these glasses. And also my robot Hoover, which you definitely need to go to Instagram to take a look at. Now, these are Givenchy. I'll put the code and stuff down below. I have to say, I don't feel like incredibly sturdy, but I feel like no steel-framed glasses ever really do, because they're quite fine, aren't they? Anyway, I've got to put my lenses in. I've got to send these back, get my lenses put in, and then I shall be wearing them all the time. But they, I should have done those first, really, because they are my first, they're my favourite of the month. A couple of beauty things, and then a fashion. This, which I have just finished both of these things. First time I've used this is the Active Clay Cleanser from Dermalogica. And it's, I feel like it's halfway between a mask and a cleanser in a way, because I tend to put it on, I leave it on for a couple of minutes, and then I use a flannel to cleanse it off. And if you like the idea of using a really sort of deep cleansing mask with clay in, but you don't like the way that you have to leave it on and sort of let it set a little bit, and then it's a bit of a pain in the ass to take it off. And also some people find those very, very drying. This is not drying in the slightest. It's been formulated to sort of balance the skin, so it's not stripping. And it does a really good job of getting makeup off. I don't like it so much over the eyes. Found that a little bit stressful. So you would use an eye makeup remover before or after. But as a really nice purifying cleanse, if you're finding you're getting a bit spotty around this area because of wearing a mask maybe, or it's just a hormonal thing, then it's well worth a try. I really like purifying products that have sort of more than one use. It doesn't really have more than one use, it's a cleanser, but you know, you can leave it on a little bit longer and it feels a bit more mask-like. So I like that a lot. In fact, I'm not going to say I love it. I love this. I love it. It's very, very good. So that's the Active Clay Cleanser. Another beauty thing that I finished, this is the second time I've finished one of these, SkinCeuticals Discoloration Defense Serum. Now, I'm going to give it to you straight. It's not cheap. However, weirdly, it's a lot cheaper than most of SkinCeuticals serums. And I think that this is my favourite one that I've ever tried. It's specifically for dark spots, okay? And I don't have any dark spots, but I did start to have dark spots last spring, summer, when I was just outside all of the time, and they just started to come up along the tops of my cheekbones and around the mouth a little bit as well. And this has just nipped them in the bud. I don't know how it would do on really stubborn, set-in dark spots, or if you've had them for a long, long time, or if they're very, very dark. I don't know. Mine were quite trivial, I suppose you would say. But did a very, very nice job of just, you know, when you just have that even skin tone and it feels like it's just very sort of clear. That's how this made it feel. I really like it. I like it a lot. Gotta think of a new word for like. Oh no, I've got too many things. I've been using this loads as well. I'm just gonna drop this in here. You saw this in the last video, so I'm not gonna go on too much about it, but it's the Ultimate Recovery Intense for dry, compromised and post-treatment skin, deeply hydrating and comforting. It's sort of like a barrier cream really. In that, you know, when your skin is just so, feels like it's going to crack or tear. Ooh, it's horrible thoughts. This is the kind of thing that you need. But that's not one of my five. That's my last five, last thing in my five, is this jumper. This is from M&M, and they just do the most amazing cashmere. Again, I'm going to get straight to it. Very, very pricey. But out of all of my expensive jumpers, they last really, really well. So, you know, they're kind of investment pieces. Now, this is from the new collection. So I don't know whether you can see the lovely stripes on it, a bit funky. But the main thing that I want to show you, and this is a reason it's in my favourites, I wouldn't just be like, hey, I love this jumper, because there are plenty of jumpers. But look at this. So it has a removable collar, what do you call that? Funnel neck. So you can have it so that it's really cash look, and it feels more like, you know, just going out in your jeans and your trainers and whatever. Or I also feel it's just slightly more dressed, isn't it? With there's a stripe there as well. Look, with the neck on. But I just think it's a nice touch, and one that I would never think of if I was designing clothes. I think I'd probably be an appalling clothes designer. But they just come out tops on most things, I think, M&M. They just cut things ever so cleverly. So all the details of things I've mentioned, they're down in the description below, and I shall see you in the next video.